Hi, welcome to this session addressing the challenge of GNSS receivers being integrated into IoT devices. I am Thierry Torletin, Engineering Director of Saint-Tony. Let's get started by a few words on my company and which part of the IoT market we are targeting. Then a brief statement on the state of the art of the GNSS cloud processing commonly proposed for low-cost application. The bulk of the presentation is focused on the innovation and finally its benefits to the market. What is Saint-Tony's approach of IoT? We are a French company, 6 years old, with now 50 people. Most of us belong to the engineering team. Our specificity is to develop solutions based on software-defined radio. We have offices and representatives in Europe, North America, and Asia. Our technology of SDR applies to the full spectrum from simulator of constellation to receivers. It allows us to offer three product lines: test and measure with a simulator and a recorder player, a new product to extend coverage underground as a smart repeaters, and receivers for aeronautics and space application, and one for the dedicated to the IoT, which is our focus right now. These products meet the need of a wide range of customers in space, aeronautics, and metros, tunnels, and mines. Thanks to our SDR approach, we are now looking at new opportunities for the receivers. This chart comes from a market study published by the European Space Project Agency. It gives an idea on how segmented is the market, from smartphone to wearable via tablets and tracker. A new segment is on the rise for GNSS, the low power asset tracker. Forecast is forecast, but the trend itself shows an opportunity, providing one can deliver the GNSS technology in that segment. It means providing a position between two periods of deep sleep mode, from 2 minutes to a day. This is the case for container, for example, asset tracking, asset moving from parking lot to another. It is about position rather than navigation. This time-to-time positioning is a challenge. The receiver has to start and retrieve information contained in the navigation message to get a fix. The implementation has to minimize the time to first fix that impact directly the consumption. Actually, there are two methods to implement a GNSS-based location in IoT. The classical method with a chipset processing the PVT locally on the object when it has no information, no external information, downlink channel, for example, the retrieval of ephemeris if through the navigation message of each satellite in view. This leads to an uptime of more than 30 seconds, even reaching the minute, depending on receiving condition. The other way around is to minimize the processing load on the processor by acquiring the RF sample only. This is a sample method, which is so-called snapshot receiver. This method has been implemented for years with variation. It is named the cloud-based GNSS positioning or PVT computation. The simplest implementation digitalizes a few 10 milliseconds or so of radio frequency sample, INQ. They are sent over the telecommunication network to a server. The server retrieves the information, like the ephemeris, from dedicated services, other server, NASA server, and or IGS server services, and compute the pseudo range, then the PVT. Easy to say, more difficult to do. Number one, beware of the energy spent to send the data over the air. 10 milliseconds, it means about 20 kilobytes of data. Number two, there are some information needed to solve the ambiguity of code to compute the pseudo range. And also the precision depends on how accurate is known the time of acquisition. It relates to the position of the satellites. Thus, the challenge is to minimize the size of data and get the information of course position. Otherwise, the solution is very much network dependent. This is where our innovation stands. The Syntony approach, that is called enhanced raw observables method, belongs to the snapshot receiver category. It adopts a cloud-based architecture. The radio frequency samples are pre-processed on the object such that it achieves number one, to minimize less than 20 bytes of data to be sent over the air. Number two, the duration of the processing on the object is less than 4 seconds. This chart shows the performance at the system level. The criteria to look at is the total energy needed. Number A, to compute the GNSS data. B, to send the data over the air. The classical method and the snapshot method perform quite well, but only in one domain. On one hand, the classical method with the receiver embedded presents an uptime of more than 30 seconds, but it only has to send 20 bytes or so of data. Whereas the snapshot method will need, say, 100 milliseconds of uptime with a huge amount of data to be transferred, 20 kbytes. The ratio on each axis is between method is 200 to 1000. So the Syntony method with a pre-processing of less than 4 seconds and 12 to 20 bytes of data maximize the pros of both methods. How to solve the ambiguity with only 10 milliseconds or so of sample? Here is an overview of the algorithm. Looking at the object, an RF front-end digitalizes 10 milliseconds of signals. A software processes them on a codes processor, for example STM32. For each satellite in view, the code phase is computed. The data are sent over the air on any telecommunication network, presumably a LPWAN, low power wide area network, to be energy efficient. The server determines a candidate area where the satellites acquired are in visibility. It applies a grid to get a fixed list of points called C. Then, the server computes the pseudo range for each satellite in view at each point and compares them with the code phase found by the object for those very satellites. The point with the smallest difference will be the course position. To solve the ambiguity, the step of the grid should be less than the length of the code. How to compare the pseudo range on the server with the code phase from the object? So here on the object side, the code phase is related to the clock offset of the satellite, the time of sampling, the pseudo range modulo t, being the period of the code. Thanks to the ephemeris, the clock offset is known. And thanks to the differential method, one satellite being chosen as a reference among the k satellites found, the time of sampling is discarded, and a sample formula comes up as shown below. It is the one that will be used for each point of the grid. Let's zoom in on each step of the process, starting with a list of candidate points. With the time of reception of the samples, the position of the SV satellite in view is known. The area on Earth where those satellites are visible is known as well. the list of candidate point C is given with a grid on this area where the step is less than the length of the L1 C course acquisition code. At each point of the grid, the k minus 1 difference of pseudorange is determined. The point with the minimum of difference between all differential code phase and all differential pseudorange for the capital K satellites found will give the course position. In other words, it is the minimum of the function giving below the on the lower part of this slide by the formula. On this chart, we have represented the result on more than 5,000 snapshots taken on an open sky, and another part of the point are taken with a mask of 90 degrees on the reception point. On the x-axis, there is the percentage of trials. On the y-axis, there is a distance between the course position found and the actual position of the reference point. With more than 7 satellites in visibility, there are 100 measures OK. What are the impact on the business of such techniques? We have been, in fact, beyond the laboratory test, we have done actually an object. Thanks to the project Apollo, which has been sponsored by the European Space Project Agency, we have embedded this technology with the Sigfox network used as the LP1. Field test has been started now for several months. We have been able to verify our expectation. The battery life measured over months of operation with one position over 15 minutes, each 15 minutes, shows an efficiency improved by 20 should one have used a chipset in cold start mode. Moreover, the integrator of the solution is not bound to a network. There is not hidden cost of implementation, whether he wants to change of a network solution depending on the use case. With this level of performance, above all, this solution is an enabler of GNSS capability where the GNSS was not previously affordable. Here is a case study submitted by a customer who was looking for a GNSS feature on a tracker, but till now the solution of the GNSS solution was discarded due to the battery life. In fact, the case study was related to the COVID-19. The solution has two major features: having a position with a period of 1 minute or so, and a size of casing allowing a very small battery of 400 mAh, because it has to be used as a wearable to detect the people doing quarantine, in fact. The classic method was not able to live more than one day, whereas Saint-Denis can offer a lot more, even more than a week, 9 days actually. This technology positions itself as an enabler in IoT for either very stringent casing or for network where no additional information is easy to be retrieved. For example, with a satellite IoT telecommunication network. Thank you for your attention. Should you have any comment, please feel free to text to us. Thank you.